Okay, here we're going to play Zulus on the Ramparts. We have the game set already. We randomly placed the Ibutos on the starting points. We have Ibutos with a combat strength of 2, 5, 3, and 4. We're ready to begin, and we start by drawing. Here we have the markers, the inti chips in the cup. So we draw the first one, and it is an R. And with the R, we have certain events that occur, but I don't think any one of them is going to apply here. So we have no Ibuto on the 3 or 4 or 5 box that has a hit that doesn't apply. None are routed. None on the 2 box. But we cannot fire on the Ibutos because the Zulus are laying low here. So we have our action, and our action is going to be to put forth John Rouse Marriott Chard. That's our action. Now we have to draw a card phase. We draw a card. We have another volley card here. So we have 3 cards. No housekeeping. That's the end of the first turn. Now we go to the second turn. We draw another chit. And this one is a 1. The loins move 1 space. That's the strongest Ibuto here to number 4. Now we have our action, and we're gonna use Chard here to remove this ammunition water low marker that gives us a -1 dial modifier. So we move him to our hand, and that marker goes for now. Now we have our card draw phase, another volley. So now we have 5 cards, which is the maximum in our hand. The hero phase now. Now we can move a hero to the tableau, and we move, this time we'll move Brumhead to the tableau. Okay. And that's the end of this turn. There's no housekeeping, so we go to the next turn. Get another impi chit. Now the right horn moves 2 spaces. So now the right horn, 1, 2. It's the weakest Zulu regiment, moves 2 spaces. Now we have our action, and we can fire at range 3, but this would reinstall the ammo low marker. Let me see here. And we would have this bonus here. This may be worthwhile. So let's fire this card. At long range, we roll 3 dice against this Ibuto here, and we would have a non-volley action afterwards for free. So we roll 3 dice. We need 6s for hits, 5s for retreat. So here we go. And we rolled 1 6. It's 1 hit. So this Ibuto suffers 1 hit. We place one of the strength markers in the Zulu casualty box. Now we have a free non-volley action. And what we're going to do is we are going to what do we want to do with this guy? Okay, we're going to put Chard here in the available box. Not a big deal. Okay. So now we have the draw card phase. Have another volley. The hero phase, we don't have heroes to put forth. No housekeeping. That's the end of the turn. Next turn, we draw another marker. Ah, this is the overheating rifles. So now we draw a marker from the cup. And let's just double check here. Yes, roll a marker from the cup. If it is an advanced marker, we implement it. If not, return the marker without effect. But we have a -1 on our volleys. So we draw another marker. If it's an advance, we implement it. No. If not, it is disregarded, right? Yeah, that's what I read. It is disregarded. Let me double check again. If it's not, return the marker without effect. Okay. And this one returns also. So now we have our action, and our action is going to be to put Marriott Chard to build barricades. So we place them in the box here for that purpose, and we take the one-third of a barricade built and we place it here. And when we finish the barricade, we will move our Zulu victory marker here to the inner barricade. Okay, so now we would have the card draw phase. It's another volley card, but it's commit the reserve platoon. We need to set up the reserve platoon to use these two cards. So these two cards are practically non-existent now. Or the reserve platoon has not been formed. Wait, it says or. You cannot fire this volley if the ammo reserve marker is in its box or the reserve platoon. Oh, so you have to comply with both. So much for that. Okay, so now we the hero phase. We have no heroes to set forth. No housekeeping. We have four cards. So we go next turn. We take an impi marker and the chest unit moves two spaces. So this Ibuto moves to number three. Okay, now we have our action. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to have Chard now build the second third of the barricade, and we signify that by placing a marker here. That's our action. Now we have our card phase, and it says this is a special event. Steady, lad, steady. Okay. So now we have our hero phase. No heroes to set forth. Discard, we have five, so we don't have more than five to discard. So now we go to the next turn. And another R. Okay, so now I think we're going to have some effects here on the R's. So let's see again. Okay, Ichibuto on the map on a 3 or 4 or 5 box that was lost in if his hit markers recovers one. Okay, we have this one is on 3, so it recovers one hit marker. We place it here. Nobody else lost any. There's none that are routed. We retreat any Ibuto which is on a 2 or lower box. That is not the case. And the Zulus have gone to ground. We cannot fire upon them. Okay, so, and this marker goes there. It's removed. So now our action is going to be to complete the barricade. So now the barricade is complete. We move the Zulu victory marker here and Marriott Chard returns to our hand. Okay, that is our action. Now we have the card draw phase, and we're going to have to discard cards here eventually. So card draw phase, another volley card, and now we have a total of 7 cards. Now we have our hero phase, and we're going to put Chard here, set him forth there. And now we have our housekeeping phase. We have to discard down to 5 hand cards. Okay, I'm gonna... Boy, 5 cards. So I'm gonna kick one of these reserve platoon cards because won't be able to use it for now. So maybe that's a mistake. We'll find out soon. Okay, so that's the end of the turn. Next turn, and now we have the left and right horn moving forward one space. So the left horn goes to 4. The right horn now is at 2. And we have an action. Okay, what's this card says? Discard to reclaim into your hand a volley card with a great title box of your choice from the discard pile in lieu of one of your card draws this turn. Okay, this assures me to get a volley card. This is a good card. So I'm not going to throw that away. So we have an action here. And I think it's time to fire at one of these groups. And I'm going to fire this one, which is the nearest one. And we will use this independent fire at will. So we discard it. We get 2 dice. And we fire. And it's a hit. We get one hit. So they don't retreat, but they suffer a hit. Okay, that was our action. We could perform an additional action if we move Brumhead here to our hand. And we could fire this card, but I don't want to run out of volley cards, just in case. This card is really bad. But this, I mean, it's good for close range. But I think I'll have to do that. Okay, move Brumhead to our hand. We have an additional action. We're going to fire this card. And the idea is try to see if we eliminate this Buto, which would be a good result. So at medium range, it is two dice. So here we go. With a six, they're gone. And we got a six, so we eliminated the Buto completely. So there's one less headache there. And so that's that. Now we draw one card, and it's another volley. So place it here. Now we have the hero phase, so we move Brumhead back to the tableau, so he's available. No discarding or housekeeping, so we go to the next turn. We pick a chit. This is the Indlugengwe forward. So this regiment, which is this one here, now moves two spaces forward. Okay. And we place it back into the cup. Now we have our actions, and that is dangerously close at two spaces. And it's medium range. This is very wimpy, and this is not very promising. But, okay. We could use this pretty soon. Okay, we have our action now. And we should try to fire. We're going to have to burn this card. Fire at will. And we're going to fire against the left horn here. So it's two dice. See, because at least a hit or a retreat. And it is two retreat results. Fives are retreats, so goes back to four. So that was pretty good. That was our action. And we could move Brumhead here to perform another action. But we can't fire this card. I don't want to waste this card right now. So, okay, Bromhead's going to stay there. So now we have the draw card phase, and we have another volley here. This is a good volley at medium range. And now we have our hero phase. No heroes to move. Do we discard this card now? No, this was during the card phase. Okay, now we're going to keep it. Okay, our hero phase, no heroes to move, no housekeeping, and that's the end of the turn. So here we continue now. Next turn, we take another, shuffle this well, another impi marker, and fire. So this is not good. Well, it may be good, depends. So we roll on the fire table on the non-ablaze column because we don't have any burning buildings. So we roll a die. It is a three. The hospital is ablaze. So we place a burning, a blaze marker here on the hospital mark, on the hospital space. And that's the action. We return the chit to the cup. Now we have an action. Okay, let's see. Okay, we finished the barricade. We should be, see if we can get that reserve platoon in soon. Although the, Ibutus are pretty far away. Could be something else we could probably do. Okay. So let's, as an action, this requires a lieutenant and a sergeant, or another lieutenant. I don't want to commit both lieutenants there. Well, that's kind of risky. So what do we do? Do we fire a volley? This is at range three. And what we have at range 3 is not good at all, so I don't want to fire a volley. So what can I do here? What can I do? Okay, we can return. You start this phase with 3 or fewer cards. No. Can we pass or something? There's nothing good to do. I mean, unless I put these two here. Well, let's do that. Okay. We put both lieutenants here. So now we have the reserve platoon formed. That's our action here. So we form the reserve platoon. And I'm going to check the rules to see if I'm doing it right. Okay, that was our action. Now we would have our card draw phase. And we have another volley. So we have now five cards, which is our max. Hero phase, no heroes to put on the tableau. And housekeeping, no cards to discard. That's it. So now we go to the next phase, or the next turn, I should say. And another R. Okay, so another R. Still haven't committed this to memory, so let's please bear with me. Each Budo unit on the map on a 3-4-5 box that has lost any hit marker recovers one. Okay, doesn't apply. And Budo units that have routed are returned to play. No, the one is here hasn't routed. Just it's been eliminated completely. Okay, retreat. Each Budo unit on the map on a 2 or lower box is retreated. We don't have that situation. But our soldiers now have to keep their heads not fired because the Zulus are laying low. Okay, so our action. What is our action going to be? What is our action going to be? I don't want to do any actions. It sounds stupid. I can't fire at anybody. Oh, we can fire this guy. Okay, range 3. But do I want to burn one of these cards? These cards are pretty good. Let's burn one. I mean, probably get a better one. Okay, this one is range... Oh, I can't fire that one because I have a fire here. Okay, so our action is going to be to put out the fire. Is that worthwhile? Because the fire is going to hold the Budo there, but may start another fire over here. Let's try to put out the fire. It's going to be our action. And to do that, I can't do that because I have to move somebody to put that fire out. So, here it is. Where is it? Fire. There's a building fire. You're going to have to buy one available hero is required to perform the action. Place the hero back in your hand. I don't want to do that. Because if I do that, the reserve platoon is gone. So I'll pass. I'll make no actions. So next is the card phase. Another volley card. Now we have 6 cards. We have to throw one out. The hero phase, no heroes. So now we have housekeeping. And we can throw one of these cards out. They're all pretty good, actually. Okay. This is the card phase, right? No, this is the housekeeping phase. I gotta throw one out. I'll throw this one out. Okay. Next turn come the Zulus. And the washing of the spears. The washing of the spears. That's good for us. Because what that means is... that the Zulus, where are they? Washing of the spears. Here it is. Look at the lowest number box on any Budo. Retreat every Budo on the same number box by 1. Okay, so the lowest number box is 3, actually. Everybody has so retreated by 1. There it is. And this stays out. Now we have our action. We can't fire at anybody, so we have to pass again. Now we have we draw a card. It says, discard to reclaim into your hand a volley card with a great deal of your choice from the discard pile. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to discard this one. And I can claim a volley card and that commit the reserve platoon that we threw. That's the one we're going to claim. So we put it here. We have five cards. Okay, so we have a hero phase, no heroes. We don't have to discard anything. We have a maximum number of cards. Now, we go again with the Zulus, the Impi phase. Now we have left and right horns moving two. So the left horn now moves to two. And the right horn is gone, so we ignore that. That's good. So now we can deal exclusively with that left horn. And we have an action. And we're at range two. And at range two, we don't have to burn our commit our reserve platoon yet. We're going to use this one. Look to your front. And we have four dice. So we discard that card and we roll four dice. Here we go. And the result is one hit. So it doesn't retreat, but it gets hit. Okay, do we want to do another action? I don't think we can. So that's our action. Draw card phase. And we have Commissary James Langley Dalton. And it says that while available, but I think, is that in a particular face here? In the Buto face, yeah. In the storehouse. So we will put his marker in the storehouse. It's kind of, it's not going to do anything there, actually, because the Ibuto that was there was eliminated. Okay. Oh, but no, we don't put him there yet because he's not available yet. So that doesn't happen. Okay, so we just got him on the draw card phase. Now we have the hero phase. And now we put him. And now technically we can put him here, even though nobody's going to come down his way there. Now we do the housekeeping. We have four cards, so that doesn't happen. Next turn. I got another marker here, and it is Prince Dabulamansi. And this one goes back to the cup when we finish. And what Dabulamansi does is we roll a die, right? And we get that number of advance markers back at the cup. So we roll a die, and it is five. And there's a total of one, two, three, four, five advance markers. So we, those are the fives there are, so we don't have to randomly select one. We just put all five there. Good. And this marker goes back. Now we have our action phase, and it should start firing away here. We have the reserve platoon. And at range two, we can probably pulverize one of these. I think we have to leave a card for this one. At range two, I'm going to use this one. This card, range two, four dice against the left horn, which we probably have a good chance of eliminating. If we get two sixes, so here we go. And we rolled, okay, a six and a five. So we have a hit and a retreat. It was hit, and it goes back to number three. Okay, so that was our action. Now we have the card draw phase. And it's another volley. Okay. Now we have the hero phase. No heroes to set forth. And housekeeping. No housekeeping. Next turn. Here we go. Here we go. Now all Sulu units move one. So the chest moves to three. Left horn, or what's left of it, to two. And the loins to three, because the right horn was eliminated. So this goes back here. And now we have an action. And I would like to eliminate this Ibuto there. So it's at range two. Here I would have one third, 33% chance of eliminating it. So do we take it? Let me see. We don't want to burn one of these cards. With this, we could probably eliminate it, but then we're going to be... Well, I'll tell you what. I'll try to do that. Okay. We're going to commit the reserve platoon. And because we're using this card, we're going to get the ammo low marker back. So we're going to fire here to try to eliminate this unit. So we roll four dice. Here are the four dice. And we need 1 6 to get rid of it. And that's what we rolled, 1 6. So it's gone. And now we get the ammunition low marker back. Okay. But at least it's gone. So we only have to worry about two of the Ibutos. And we're not even halfway through the deck. So that was our card, our action. Now we go to our draw card phase. And night fighting begins. So play, discard immediately. The night rule now applies for the rest of the game. So we're going to pause right now. So we play this card, discarding it immediately, and we have the night rules. But the night rules won't have any effect because we have a fire on the hospital. So there's no minus one to our volleys because it's considered to be the area illuminated because of that fire. So we go to the next impi chit. And the loins advance one space, and the loins are the scariest one here. To their number two, so we have an action now. And now we have the problem of the ammunition water low. But we could use Commissary James Langley Dalton to do that for us. So, I think we're going to do that. So, or because if we fire now, it's with a minus one, and it would be a shame to use the reserve platoon for that. So, with this minus one penalty, so we put Dalton back in our hand, and we remove the minus one penalty. Okay, now we have the card draw phase. We draw a card, and we have another volley. So we have the maximum cards. Hero phase, we put Dalton back here. And now, housekeeping, no effect. Okay, so we go to the next turn. And we have, again, Prince Duo, what's his name? Dabulamansi. But this time it says they are returned to the cup on day turns only. So he's not going to be returned this time. So we roll a die to see how many advance markers. We can pick three. There is a total of two, so that's all they can recover. Two, and this time the prince does not return to the cup. Okay, because we are in a night turn. Oh, I forgot to put here, we are in the night right now. Let's put the night marker. Okay, so now we have our actions, and now we can fire really nice volley. Let me see here. Yeah, it's going to be going to commit the reserve platoon and fire four dice at the loins, this Ibuto here. Here we go. Of course, the ammo low return, the ammo low marker will return. And that is a total of one hit and one retreat. So we have one hit, and it retreats to number three. And we place this marker back in the ammunition water low penalty. Okay, and we just use this card, so it's gone. Do we want to do additional actions? Let me see. We have Dalton in the storehouse. He's well available. He's there. Okay, it's not going to have any effect. So let's see. We don't have these guys anymore. I think we can return them now. Here, we're going to do that because we don't have any more of those cards, so they return here. And now we go to our card draw phase, and we're going to have six cards, fire at will, so we're going to have to get rid of one. And okay. Now we have our hero phase, so we won't have to get rid of any card. We move Brumhead here, so we now have five cards. Okay, housekeeping. We don't have to remove cards. And, oh, we removed the reserve platoon is gone. So, here we go. Pick another chit. And, uh-oh. The loins move three. Uh-oh, this is bad. Here we go. One, two, and they're about to win the game. Three, one more space, and they win the game. I didn't know they could move three, so that's pretty bad. So that leaves us with no choice. We got to fire at the loins there. And the best card we have is this Ready and Guard, which is four dice. So we're going to, as our action, discard this card, four dice. Here against this Ibuto, the outer perimeter. And we have this minus one penalty. Wait a second. We're firing with this card. Wait a second. Let's bring this card back here. Okay, so what we'll have to do is we have one action. The action's going to be, okay, Dalton is going to remove. By putting him here, we remove the ammunition water low. Okay. And now by returning Brumhead also, we have an additional action at this time. And now we're going to fire this card with no penalty, the Ready and Guard card. So we have four dice against the Buto here. Here we go. We have a total of two hits and one retreat. So two hits, that leaves the unit with two. And it retreats one space back here. So that was very good. And that was our... that's our action phase. Now we draw a card, and we're going to have to... oh, Surgeon James Henry Reynolds. Is this card going to be available? Okay, put him here. Now we have our hero phase, and we're going to put Brumhead here. And now we're going to have a problem, because we have 3, 4, 5, 6 cards. Just did our hero phase. Now we have to discard one card. Discard one card. It's going to be one of these crappy volleys. Okay. I think it's going to be this one. We discard this card. Okay. There you go. And now we go to the Zulu turn, starting with the Impi Chitro. And here we have the snipers. So what that means is that we draw another chit. And it is an advance by the left and right horn. So the left horn is gone, and the right horn is also gone, so nothing happens. And this marker, the snipers, chit is returned to the MP cup. This always returns. Okay. Now we have our actions. And we still have these guys very close at range one. And we can fire this card. So we're going to fire this card, volley fire, present fire, three dice against that Ibuto. Here we go. This time we get an additional hit. So one more hit and they're gone, but we couldn't make it retreat. Okay. So we could have one more action with Brumhead if we move him here, but it would be at a range of one. I don't think it's worth it. So I'll take my chance there. But if he's called to advance two, it's the end of the game. And I don't want to sacrifice Brumhead here now. So one additional action. I'm gonna go with one die. Okay, so that's it. Now we draw a card. We have another hero. We have too many heroes now. And now we have the housekeeping. No, we have maximum number of cards. So now we move to the next turn. And that's the Sulu's turn. And we pick a car, chit. And it is, everybody moves one. So this is getting close here. Okay, the chest moves to two. Now the loins move to zero, one space from victory. And that's it. And now we have an action. And somebody, we're going to have to probably sacrifice Bromhead here. I don't like that. Because we have this volley here. So we'll have to fire this volley first. This is at range one. It's really range zero, but you use range one. So it's one die. Here we go. Against this Ibuto here. It's a one. It fails. So now we have no choice. And we have to sacrifice Brumhead for four dice against that this Ibuto. So he goes to the discard pile, which is truly a shame. But we get four die rolls. And with a six, we eliminate that Ibuto. So here we go. And we didn't roll a six. We rolled a five, which moves it back one space and gives us some room there. Okay. So now we go to our card draw phase and we get a volley. Hero phase. So I think I'm going to place Reynolds in the tableau. Okay. And now it is the housekeeping phase. And in the housekeeping phase, is take one hero card of your choice from the discard pile and make it immediately available. So I'm going to take Bromhead, make him available, but roll a die. One, two, or three, discard this card. On a five or six, insert this card face down into the approximate center of the pile. Let's see. Okay, we got a six, so we insert it face down approximately in the center of the pile. So this is the pile, what's left. I think the center of the pile would be like this. No, too many. Okay. Here we go. So we place it in the center of the pile. So that effectively adds one more card to our time, to our card deck, which doubles as a time deck. Okay, so that was that. Housekeeping, we don't lose any cards. The Zulus go again. Here we go. And this time, fire again. So we roll on the fire table. And let's see what happens. We have one ablaze, which is a hospital. Five, no effect. So we return this here. And now we have one action. This is at range one, two dice. And I say, let's go for it. Let's try to eliminate this unit. So two dice with a six. We send them into oblivion. Let's see. And we roll a six. So this Buto is gone. And that was our action. Now we draw a card and we need more volley cards. No, we got too many heroes. Okay. And now we have our hero phase. And Bromhead is back, all right, because we brought him back. So we have five heroes. We're going to move Bromhead to the tableau here, okay? No housekeeping. So now we go to the next turn. Now this game's becoming interesting. Just one Ibuto left, and it is here in the chest track, and there it has a fire in front of it. So we draw another Impi Chit. And this one reads, right horn moves two, but there's no right horn. They were eliminated. So that gives us a chance to fire on these guys, but we don't have any fire cards. Any, how do you say, any, volley cards. Okay, so, as an action, what can we do here? I don't want to put out that fire. I don't want to sacrifice anybody. We can't use these, can't fire actually because the fire's there. So I guess I pass on the action, we draw a card. And another hero now, we got too many heroes. And that is the card phase, the hero phase. I can put forth a hero. So I am going to put forth this one. This one has a very powerful discard capability. I can switch the MP chip that comes out. And that's the hero. Housekeeping, no housekeeping. Now next turn. Here we go. And next turn reads left horn one. Nope. Left horn is nobody's there. One. So we have an action. And gotta try to fire this guy somehow. I have to let's see. Okay. So we pass on the actions. And next thing is card draw. Need a volley here. Okay, you have a volley. Good. And now our hero phase. We can put forth another hero. We're going to put Henry Hook up forth. At the supervisory, housekeeping. Nope, nothing. So now we go to the next turn. We draw an MP chit here. And now the loins move, but the loins are out of the game. So that doesn't happen. And now we're going to, well, we can't fire. We have to put out that fire first if we want to fire these guys. So we have no actions. We pick a card. It's another volley card. And now we, the hero phase, we can move this one here too. So we got four heroes there. And now, housekeeping, no. Next turn. Now we have a fire again. So we roll on the fire table. Fire table, here we go. Four, because we have one ablaze, no effect. Okay, so what is our action going to be? See, if I put out the fire, I can start firing away that unit. So I'm gonna try to put out the fire, and to put out the fire, I just have to move one of these guys over. So I'm gonna move Shias back, and we roll on the firefighting action table. So here we go. Two, no effect. So that failed. That was our action. Now we draw a card. We have another volley. And now it's hero time. So we'll place Marriott Chard here. And we don't have to discard down to five cards. That's it. So next. And we draw another chit. And this time it reads right horn one. Right horn doesn't exist, so it doesn't move. Now we have an action. We're going to try to put the fire away, off away. We're going to put Chard here. Try to do that. So we roll a die again. Try to put out the fire. With a four, one fire extinguished. So the fire is gone. Okay, so we did that. And now we have the hero phase. Hero face? Yeah. So we put the hero back here. Housekeeping? No. We have the maximum number of cards. So next turn. And it reads, fire again. And we... You see this fire is coming up to my... Oh, okay. This chit is returned to the MB cup. Oh, yeah, it's returned. Okay. So the fire again. So we roll on the non-ablaze, a two, the hospital is ablaze again. That didn't help. Okay, so now we have the British action. What can we do? We can construct a barricade, right? Okay, so let's send Marriott Chard to build a barricade. So we place the, we could have done that. Okay, here, the first third, there. Now we take, we go to the card phase, and we have Surgeon General Reynolds. Hero phase, so we can move Shias here. Housekeeping, now we can preserve our cards, that's it. We got another one. And now we have the loins moving too, but the loins are out. That doesn't happen. Action. Okay, we're gonna try to put Dalton to put off the fire. So here we roll again. Firefighting action. 5. 1 fire extinguished. So it's gone. That was our action. Now look at what we're gonna do now. We're gonna move Brumhead, who moves back here, and he can perform one action. And then action we are going to perform, that is at range 2, is, oh boy, it's going to be low, ammunition low again. No, let's go with this one first. 2 dice, here we go, and it doesn't lower our ammunition status, and it is a failure. Okay. So that's that. The card draw phase. Draw another card, and it's a volley card. Now we have too many cards. Hero phase, so we move Brumhead back here. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we can remove one card. And that's going to be this one. Let me see now. This is ammo low. You know. Reduce this card. Okay. So now we go again. Pick a chit. And Yeah, but this clan doesn't exist anymore. So that's it. Indigoya forward. And this was not supposed to return, actually. So let's disregard it. Pick another one. Because that one wasn't supposed to be there. Okay. And we have the snipers again. We pick another one. See if anybody advances. The left horn, too. No, the left horn is not operational anymore. And this sniper is returned to the MP cup. Okay. Actions. Now we can fire on this Ibuto. And let me see. I'm going to fire. This card, I want 3 dice here. Okay, 3 dice, and we'll have to put the ammo low back marker back in the, so we roll 3 dice. Here we go. We need some hits here. We only get a retreat. Okay, that's the end of our action. Now we take a card. And Lauren Chelmsford, relief column. You survived. The game is over. See rule 11 to determine the victory level that you have achieved. We'll check that right now. Okay, let's score the points. We have a total of 8 points here for metal bearing characters that are available or committed. We have for each Zulu hit marker, we have 7. It's 3 points, so it's 21 plus the 8, 29. 4 for each hospital storehouse not burning, so that's 8 more points. So that's now 29 plus 8 plus 29 plus 8, 37. We have 6 for each Buto marker here, 18. So 37 and 18 is 55, and 10 more points because the relief column is here. 65. This, none of these apply. 65 is epic Zulu, epic victory, Zulu debacle. So it's an epic victory by all standards. So I hope I played it right, and I'll check the tape. But in any event, thanks for watching. This was a game of Zulus on the Ramparts.